This lesson, what is that? Early civilizations. This is the sixth lesson. What is that? Early civilizations. Yesterday we learned about the Indus Valley civilization. Okay, today we learn next civilization. What is the next one? Is the Vedic civilization. This is the Vedic civilization. These are classified into two groups. One is the early Vedic civilization. One is early Vedic civilization. First one is early Vedic civilization and second one is later Vedic civilization. Later Vedic civilization. Okay. Yesterday I told about the civilization means civilized. Civilized city. Nagarika. Nagarikata pondina oka desam ledante oka prantham ani artham. So this is the Vedic civilization is divided into early Vedic civilization and later Vedic civilization. Today I want to explain about the early Vedic civilization. Okay, so which location is there? Means this early Vedic civilization in which place is flourished in the ancient time? In which place? It is near the Indus and Saraswati rivers. These are the near the place of the Indus means Sindhu river. These are in the northern place of our India. This is the northern part of our India have the Indus river and the Saraswati river. This Saraswati river is not have nowadays. Why? Because these are the Ghaggar and Hakra rivers which are flowing into the Thar desert. Which are flowed into the Thar desert near the Rajasthan. This is the Saraswati river. In ancient time, near 1000 years, 5000 years ago, the Ghaggar and the Hakra rivers are flowed into the Thar desert, which is near the Rajasthan. Okay, and it is also the plains of Ganga and Yamuna. Ganga, Yamuna plains. This Vedic civilization also flourished near the Ganga, Yamuna plains. Okay, of these people, from where, which people are living here in this area, maximum Indo-European groups of people are came here. Some historians' imagination is that some Indo-European groups are Central Asian people. Central Asian people and Arctic region people. Arctic region. Arctic region and Alp and East Alps. And East Alps people etc. came this. This is the imagination of the historians. What they are telling here, the Vedic civilization people who are living in that area, they came from the Central Asian people or the Arctic region people or the East Alp people or the Indo-European groups of people living in that place. Okay. And how we know this? What is the sources of this? How can we know these people are lived there? There are two type of sources are there. One is literary source. What is that? This is the Vedas. Vedas and epics. And here pottery. One is pottery and iron. These are the different sources we can know. In these people who are living in Vedic religion, Vedic civilization, those people are called Aryan civilization. It is also called Aryan. Aryan. Aryan people. They are called Aryan people. What is the sources? Vedas. I think everybody know that. How many Vedas are there? Four Vedas are there. How many Vedas? Four Vedas. And epics are two epics. Two epics. What are they? Mahabharata and Ramayana. Ramayana and Mahabharata are the two epics. And the Vedas are four Vedas. Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Adharvana Veda. Why can we tell the Mahabharata or in the Ramayana serials, the kings call to each other Aryan. Aryan, they can say, if you observe that, the Dasaratha Maharaja is called to his son Rama Aryan like that. So Arya people are lived in that time, the sources are telling to us. And also has some pots. When they are used, some pots are we find from the earth, and the iron tools, and the, which tools they used, which what is the sword, like that, a sword, a knife, and what type of tools they are used in that time, we find in the ground, in the earth. So we can say that these iron and potters are pots also there in the source, are the sources of Vedic civilization. Okay, and what is the Vedic literature? Vedic literature, what is that? Veda means superior knowledge. Veda means superior knowledge, means very good knowledge. If we read the Vedas, we can get very good knowledge about it. About it is also called as Shruti. Vedas also called as Shruti. And these are the universal truths are there in Vedas. Universal truth means it will not be false, it will not be not wrong at any time. These are the universal truths. Ekkadikaina gaani manu vedanante ee Vedas lo unde vishayalu, Veda lo unde shlokalu, padyalu, avi eppudu kuda truth annamata, avi eppudu kuda avi tappu kaane kaavu. So that type of truths are there in the Vedas. And bedrocks of the philosophy and yoga, these Vedas of bedrock means punadi anamatavi. They are the bedrocks of philosophy, tattvaniki. Ante mana poojalu cheyadam gaani, poojalu cheyadam vala maniki moksham vastundi, ledante maniki ento punyam kalugutundi, swargam, narakam, ivanni mana nowadays we are telling, no. These are the bedrock of the Vedas. These are the basis of basement of these Vedas. And yoga. Yoga, what yoga? Yoga means if we go do good, we can be good. If we do bad, we can be bad. That is the yoga about that. Okay. These are the came by the Vedas. And still continue and it will not be unbroken. Nowadays we are accepting this all. And after so many centuries also it will be accepted, it will not be broken. Okay. Swami Dayananda Saraswati, he is the scholar and the philosopher. Swami Dayananda Saraswati, what he told him? He told to go back to the Vedas. It means go back to the Vedas, means go and read the Vedas. What is there in that Veda? In Vedas, there are the universal truths are there. So many good things are there. How to live one human being? Everything is there in the Vedas. So if we read these Vedas, we can get so much knowledge. That is the superior knowledge. Okay. And about this, understood everybody? Vedic civilization is a classified into early Vedic civilization, later Vedic civilization. This is the early Vedic civilization, which is a location near the Indus and the Saraswati rivers and plains of Ganga and Yamuna. People who are living in the Vedic civilization are called Aryan people, and they came from Indo-European groups and Central Asian Arctic region, East Alp mountains. Historians' imagination is there. Okay, and how can we know about the Vedic people? By the source of literacy and archaeological sources. One is the Vedas and epics, and pots and irons we get from the underground, under the earth, we can know about the Vedic civilization. So already I told about the Vedas. There are four Vedas are there. They are written in ancient time when the Vedic period is, Vedic civilization is there. On that time, only these Vedas are written by the rishis. Okay, what is that? Four Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Adharvan Veda. These are the four Vedas. So I want to tell about the Vedas are there. It means in Rig Veda, what is there in the book? So Vedic hymns and then about the rishis, Vedic hymns. Vedic hymn means padyalu anamata. Padyalu, shlokalu, ippudu manam edaina oka festival chestunnam ankonde, andulo chala shlokalu chadutha untaru, padyalu chadutharu, inka mantralu chadutha untaru purohiti. These all are came by the Rigveda only. Okay, hymns means shlokalu or mantras. Shlokas are mantras. Next one is the Yajurveda. It is the detailed rules of the sacrifice life. It is the detailed rules for sacrifice life. If anybody want to go in by to take sannyasam, evarina sannyasam teeskovalanukunnaranukondi, they want to leave all his family and his all his property, all his money, everything, and he should go in the prayer of the God only. That is what to do if anybody want to go to join in ashramas. If anybody want to go to outside of the house, what to do? All rules we can know about the Yajurveda. These are the detailed rules for sacrifice of life. Okay, and next one is the Samaveda. Samaveda is the collection of songs. So many songs are there in that. In our old ancient songs and origin of songs, like Karnataka Sangeet and Tyagaraja Sangeet, like this, so many songs are came by the Samaveda, and then so many ragas also there in Samaveda. Okay, next one is Atharvana Veda. Atharvana Veda is the collection of spells and charms. Spells and charms means so many mantras are there. Chala mantralu, inka shlokalu, ivanni kuda ee Atharvana Veda lo undayi anamata. For example, Vinayaka Chavithi ga isthunnam anukondi man festival. On that time, we use different type of mantras or shlokas. If we are celebrating Dasara or Sankranti, if we go to different type of festivals, if we are celebrating, or sometimes some kings are doing some yajnas, yagas, on that time all the priests are spells like this, charms, charm and shloka. ఇప్పుడు మనం ఏ గుడిలోకి వెళ్ళినా కానీ ఎక్కడైనా కానీ పురోహితులు ఏం చేస్తూ ఉంటారు, మంత్రాలు చదువుతూ ఉంటారు. ఒక దేవుడి దేవి ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మన మా ఊళ్ళో మన టెంపుల్కి వెళ్ళినా కానీ, లేదంటే ఏదైనా ఒక వేరే టెంపుల్లో వెళ్ళినప్పుడు, ఇంకా ఎవరైనా చనిపోయినప్పుడు కూడా కొన్ని మంత్రాలు చదువుతూ ఉంటారు. లేదంటే ఒక బర్త్డే పార్టీ బర్త్డేకి నామకరణం చేస్తారు చిన్నపిల్లలకి, అటువంటి వేరే మంత్రాలు. ఇలా ప్రతి దానికి కూడా ఈ వేరే వేరే మంత్రాలు శ్లోకాలు అనేవి ఈ యజుర్వేదలో ఉంటాయి అన్నమాట. ఫ్రమ్ అథర్వణ వేద వీ కెన్ నో ఆల్ దీస్ శ్లోకాస్ అండ్ మంత్రాస్. అబౌట్ దీస్ ఫోర్ వేదస్ ఇస్ ఆర్ ద ఋగ్వేద, యజుర్వేద, సామవేద అండ్ అథర్వణ వేద. అండ్ దీ అండ్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ దీస్ వేదస్, దేర్ ఆర్ టూ ఎపిక్స్ ఆల్సో దేర్. వన్ ఇస్ రామాయణ అని రామాయణ అండ్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఇస్ మహాభారత. సెకండ్ వన్ ఇస్ మహాభారత. ఓకే, ఫ్రమ్ దీస్ ఎపిక్స్ వాట్ కెన్ వీ నో అబౌట్ ఇన్ ద రామాయణ? వీ కెన్ నో అబౌట్ ద రామ, హౌ ఈస్ ద ఐడియల్ మ్యాన్, ఐడియల్ కింగ్, ఐడియల్ హస్బెండ్ అండ్ ఐడియల్ బ్రదర్ అండ్ ఐడియల్ సన్, లైక్ దట్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ వీ కెన్ నో అబౌట్ ఇన్ ద రామాయణ. ఒక ధర్మబద్ధంగా ఎలా ఉండాలి, ఒక మనిషి ఒక మంచిగా ఎలా ఉండాలి అనేది మనం రామాయణం చూసినట్లయితే మనకి అందులో ఉండే ప్రతి క్యారెక్టర్ ద్వారా కూడా మనం కొత్తగా మనం నేర్చుకునే మన జీవితంలో అలవర్చుకుని మనం ఒక మంచి వ్యక్తిగా మనం నిలగడానికి ఈ రామాయణ ఈజ్ వెరీ యూస్ఫుల్ టు అస్. లైక్ దట్ ఇన్ ద మహాభారత, ఇన్ మహాభారత దేర్ ఆర్ కౌరవాస్ అండ్ పాండవాస్ ఆర్ దే. వాట్ హ్యాపెన్డ్, ద పాండవాస్ ఆర్ ఓన్లీ 5 members, ద కౌరవాస్ ఆర్ 100 members, బట్ దే ఆర్ ద bad people, bad men, and but in the Pandavas are very good people. They are the 5 brothers are very good men. They are, so what happened in the Mahabharata, the very big Kurukshetra has done in the Mahabharata. So what happened, who went in that Kurukshetra? Pandavas only in that war of the Kurukshetra. Why? Because they are very good. If any person is not good, what will happen? He will spoil, his life will be spoiled at the end. If any person is very good, like in the Mahabharata or like Ramayana, his life will be very good. We can know this moral from this Ramayana and Mahabharata. So, next one is Brahmanas. These also written in the Vedic civilization or in the Aryan time. What is meant by Brahmana? These are the prose of 5 ritual and philosophies. Prose of 5 means which are the slogans and mantras are there, no? That meaning is there in the Brahmanas. The meaning of that slogans and mantras are there in the Brahmanas and the rituals. And the ritual and the acharam, what type of prayer should we do in the Vinayaka Chavithi, or what type of prayer we should in so many festivals are there in what are there, Sri Rama Navami, Krishna Ashtami, like so many festivals are there. What type of praying we should do? Means these are the ritual and the philosophy. Philosophy means tattvam anamata. Tattvam ante manam em chesthe manam bhakti margamlo veltam. Ilanti tattvalanni kuda ee brahmanas lo manam telusukovachu. Okay, next one is aranyakas. What is the next one? This is the aranyakas. First one is brahmana, second one is aranyaka. Deal with mysticism and the rites and the ritual. Mysticism ante manaki teliyani vishayalu ante, for example, mysticism means for example Annamaya. Annamaya is a devotee of Sri Venkateswara and Bhakta Ramadas is a devotee of Rama. How they are in mysticism. Mysticism ante oka devuni manam chusinappudu manam ela undam parvasam aipothamu anamata. Aa devuni enta baagunnadu, enta andamga unnadu, ila manam em avutamo oka daantlo velipotham, oka rakamaina maikamlo velipotham. Why? Because they saw the directly God, Annamaya and Bhakta Ramadas like that, so they feel very very good. In the so many movies also there, when we see the God directly, how will we feel? Very happy. We can be into mysticism, that is called mysticism. Okay, and after the rites and ritual, samskar means ritual, means samskar ante oka pillavadu putinappudu gaani, oka marriage time, lekapothe oka festival time, or if anybody had died, some rituals we do on that time. Rituals ante konni aacharalu anamata, ante edo oka pillavadu putinappudu namakaranam cheyadam, avani uyyalo veyadam, ఇంకా మ్యారేజ్ అయినప్పుడు కొత్త రకంగా వాళ్ళు ఒక సంస్కారం ఉంటుంది, అంటే ఎలా చేయాలి మ్యారేజ్, ఏ రకంగా చేయాలి, ఫస్ట్ డే, సెకండ్ డే, థర్డ్ డే, ఇలా. ఇంకా అంతేకాకుండా ఒక వ్యక్తి చనిపోయినప్పుడు కూడా కొన్ని సంస్కారాలు మనం పూర్తి చేయవలసి ఉంటుంది అనమాట. అవన్నీ కూడా మనం ఎక్కడ నుండి నేర్చుకున్నాం అంటే దీస్ ఆర్ ఫ్రమ్ అరణ్య కార్డ్స్. వీ కెన్ లర్న్ ద డీల్ విత్ ద మిస్టిసిజం, రేట్స్ అండ్ రిచువల్స్. అండ్ లాస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ ద ఉపనిషత్. Upanishad dealing with the soul, mysteries of nature. This is a dealing with soul. Soul means Atma. Atma rolane untam oka sari manama. We can do the meditation. If we do the meditation, we go into the one other land. That is a mystery. Mystery dealing with the soul. That is the meaning with soul. Manam ide control chestam anamata. Ante mana atmanu manato paatu emichukoni maname దాన్ని కంట్రోల్ చేయడం, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ డీలింగ్ విత్ సో. అండ్ ఆల్సో ద మిస్టరీస్ ఆఫ్ నేచర్. నేచర్ సీ హౌ గుడ్ దిస్ నేచర్. సో మెనీ ఫ్లవర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్, డిఫరెంట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లవర్స్, డిఫరెంట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ కలర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్, అండ్ డిఫరెంట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రూట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్. హౌ వన్ ఫ్రూట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ద సేమ్ టు అదర్. డిఫరెంట్ సీడ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్, డిఫరెంట్ కలర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ ద ఫ్రూట్స్ అండ్ వెజిటేబుల్స్. ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఇన్ ద nature. This is the mysteries of the nature, about the nature, how the God has created all this. These are detailed notes is there in the Upanishads about the nature and about the soul. How can we create to ourselves good thing, good man, or a good human being? We can if we can read all these Vedas, epics, Brahmanas, Aryankas and Upanishads, if we read all this, we can be a very good human being, and we can be a very devotee, and we can be a very polite, we can be a very obeying, we can be a very good person. Is this? So these are the helpful to the person to be a good man. The life of Vedic civilization people means Aryan civilization. People who are living in the Vedic civilization, they are called Aryans. Okay. What is the social life? In the society, the family head is the father is the family head. Head of the family is the father. And in the society, there are so many joint families on there. I think everybody knows joint family, father, mother, grandmother, grandfather, auntie, uncle, everybody. Means in one house, nearly 10 to 15 members can live along with them. These are called the joint families. This type of families are there in the society. And there also have some dasas. Who are these? Dasa means slaves, or prisoners, if anybody doing any mistake, they kept into the prison, they are called the prisoners. These prisoners are taking as the dasas to do household work or in the agriculture anyway. If anybody want to do some work, they are taking dasas by paying money to the government. Okay, and also have the monogamy is following there. Monogamy means one person have only one wife only. That is called the monogamy. So this is the social life in the Vedic civilization. And the position of women. Position of women means how the respected women in the time. For women, what is the respect in that society, in the royal families, in the families, how the women are respected. She is a very respectable woman. Means chala maryada puramga women ni chusevaru anamata. And also women also studied Vedas. Yeah, just now I told now Vedas, epics, and these are Brahmanas, Aranyakas, all these are studied by women also. And also there is no child marriage and no sati sahagamana in the society. I think everybody know the child marriage. Children, very small girls is doing the marriage, that is not having the society. And sati sahagamana means sati sahagamana. Sati sahagamana means if any couple, for husband if he died, the wife should be go into the fire. If the husband's there is burned the husband, the sati also go there, and she should be burned in that fire. That is not there in the society when early Vedic period. Okay, next one, Gosha, Lopamudra, Apala, Indrani and Vishwara are the Vedic scholars in this famous women's. They are means they are the scholar and Vidwans. They can know everything in the epics and in the Vedas. They are the called the scholars. They are the important women's are there in early Vedic period. They are the Gosha, Lopamudra, Apala, Indrani, Vishara. These are the different names of the particular women. Okay, these are the scholars in the early Vedic period. And the dress, what type of dresses they wear, what type of clothes they are wearing in the early Vedic period. In the early Vedic period, they wear dhoti. Dhoti means they are called that dhoti as vasa. Vasa means in the down we are wearing, nowadays we are wearing pant and shirt. Why? Because the Britishers came and they changed the quarter of their dressing style. But in the ancient time, there is no pants and no shirts.